Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2356, filter the function by column. Hey, first, a shout out to Gaetan, who gave me a comment on a video from 100 videos ago, 2252. And he said, you know, this seems to work well. And I couldn't figure out this formula at all. It was using the filter, but I went into evaluate formula, and about 11 steps in, all of a sudden, the what to filter by evaluates to this array constant that was telling me which columns I want. And the light bulb went on. I'm like, holy smokes. Most of the time, the filter function is giving us certain rows, but Gaetan showed me that it could also give us certain columns. So I'm gonna ask for the filter. I'll choose this whole table over here, comma. And then what do I want to include? It's gonna be an array constant with commas in between. So I just look at the data. Item, I don't need that, so zero. Buyer, yep, I want that. City, nope. State, nope. Phone number, yes. Sold, no. Paid, no. Cost, yes. Quantity, no. Total, no. Close the array constant, close paren, and I got buyer, phone, and cost. All right, so that's hard coding, but it would also be possible to do something where we put a formula in. I just want buyer and state. So check this out. This formula has an XMATCH, or you could do match. Look through the headers and see, looking for this table, buyer or state. That's actually going to return either NA if it's not found, or where it's found if it's found. 1, 2, 3, those are all considered as true. So I wrap that in if NA to change the NA to 0, and I get state and buyer. Right, this is cool. Here's another one. Here's a schedule for the month, and I only want to show the columns where I'm scheduled to see someone that day. So I had a helper row at the top that counts how many appointments there are that day. And then out here, this formula says equal filter of the schedule, and I want A1 to F1. If it's non-zero, I'll get the column. If it's zero, I won't get the column. Now, the hassle here is that the filter function returns zeros for empty, and so I had to hide those zeros with the semicolon, semicolon, semicolon at the end, or I could have used a let function. So let A equal the filter, and then if A equals zero, give me nothing, otherwise A. Either one will work. All right, but check this out. So right now I have 8, 4, 8, 7. Let's go to 8, 6 and schedule someone. So 1 p.m. I press enter, and then over here, 8-6 appears. I have to extend my number formatting. This is an awesome trick. I don't know if this was obvious to you. It certainly wasn't obvious to me until I saw Gaetan's formulas. Gaetan, thanks for posting that comment on YouTube. If you don't have one of my Excel guru patches, write me an email. I will be happy to send you one for that. Down below this video, please click like, subscribe, and ring that bell. We're all Excel fans. When I discover something new and cool in Excel, I want to share it with you. Click subscribe so you can be the first to know about it. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly. Gaetan, thanks for making that book obsolete. And this book obsolete, I'll have to update that. But I love the new trick. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Gaetan for posting that. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel.